100th time a mewing is heard.
The kittens are coming to spread the word.
The kittens are coming to put on a show.
Improv comedy, both highbrow and low.
We'll do a few sketches, we'll play a few games.
We'll give you the rules, we'll tell you our names.
And when we are done and the hall is bereft,
you can bet your best catnip our mark will have left.
So, take out your knives and step in for a look.
Because the barbecue kitten is about to come!
Major, and I'm a musician.
Hello, my name is Mason Barr. I am a junior, not sophomore, music performance major. And I'm from Washington. Marketing double major from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Yeah!
And, I'm the president of BBQK.
I wonder.
mistake. At Family Video.
So the next we're going to be playing is Shoulda Said. And with this, we have Zach and Chris on stage. They're going to be performing scenes, saying words, doing things like so.
Hey, how you doing?
Double of the whistle and...
Oh, it's pretty wet out today, isn't it?
He'll change what he says or does, and it's just to my whim. I could really just do whatever I want. So, with that in mind, can I get a relationship from the audience?
Brand new breakdancers!
Into my mouth.
What?
Throw the pear into my nose. Throw the pear into my shirt.
What?
You mean this pear? I shall not do that. You look like a man who likes pear. Is this a wrong assumption?
No. I like me some pears.
Do you like this pear that I hold?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good. It's the only pear I see out here. So, considering my options, I think that's a pretty good looking pear.
You understand what pear this is, correct? This is the last pear. This pear has superpowers. This pear is a pretty normal pear.
What have we been standing out here? I thought you took me to the pear farm, not the grenade farm. Try to do that again.
David, I'm trying to teach you how to survive a grenade blast. I am here for one reason. To throw this grenade. I've had it for years.
I'm here to accept it. You know what? Put it in my mouth.
Hey, I'm not trying to kill you. I am going to murder you. Smell the grenade. Smell the grenade.
You have to smell
the grenade. Smell the pear.
You have to taste the grenade.
My name is Yorika. This is my friend.
Dave. I am troubled, some would say.
He doesn't actually work here. He just comes to listen to the music because it makes him feel better.
It soothes me, really. But I'm here and I'm ready to participate. Hello, everybody out there. Like I said earlier, my name is David. Let's get to the
good
point.
Job,
I'm
David.
Feeling nervous.
David, it's okay. All right, for our first song, do you want to introduce it?
Our first tune is a good one. Our first tune is called Lay on My Couch, and it's a really, really good, good tune.
Helped him a lot. Hi, let's hear it.
Your trouble. Well, you know the thing I say to you every time. Come sit on my couch. And once you're on my couch, nice and cozy, you can sleep the day off if you're dozy. But preferably, I would like you to talk about your problems in the comfort of my nice maroon couch. I'll even sit down next to you so I don't impose my height on you. Because I know that makes some people uncomfortable. And this is a place of comfort here on my couch. Come sit on my couch. Ooh, come sit on my couch. Yeah, come sit on my couch. Ooh, you'll be nice and cozy. I mean, I thought it was very interesting about this
this CD that they got both perspectives from, you know, the psychiatrist side and then also the people who are troubled side.
Absolutely.
This next one, you know, I'm very glad that Fall Out Boy was able to come.
Yeah.
And this tune called It's Not a Phase, Mom is really great.
Smelling the pheromones that are produced by another human being to determine whether or not they're the optimal mate. Clearly, we have our answer. Okay. So, as we discussed on Syllabus Day, week one, we knew we were going to get to the mail day linguistics. So just sit back, relax, okay? Don't be overwhelmed.
Be sure to put your phones on silent. This is a very important part of the seminar.
Crucial that you hear every detail about what we have to say.
If you tell your ferret a wrong letter, it could result in a hospital visit for you and then your ferret because it'll need therapy.
And it'll never learn to speak. And what's the point of having a ferret that can't talk?
I bet you read the ferret, man. And until you knew how to speak, it just wasn't the same.
Anyway, let us begin the lesson.
All right, Justin.
I will be the ferret, and he will teach me the most basic tools.
Straight
from Yale studies that are put out. As you can tell, 60% of you were unsure.
Approximately.
Classic Mendelian behavior. Uncertainty. We are the most uncertain species. Anyway, we understand that you may not know where.
Just in your legal talking subsidies.
I actually know a guy who knows a guy. Whose mom, she breeds ferrets on the top of a building Skyline Bro.
Super crazy.
Ferret breeder. And that's where I got my connection. So if you need my number, just hit me up.
Seriously. And guys, it's more of a plug. You're not paying for this, but yeah, we can get you some really good ferrets.
Usually about $60 a pop, I can see about getting you a dealer.
Anyway, moving on.
How sad is this communicated non-verbally?
For example... what I just showed you was fine. That is a very common thing that human beings do.
One that I see most often among college students happens to be the simple...
or, the less often, but both valid, fetal position.
Now, Justin, I've seen you in that position more than once.
Anyway, get pissed. So, dogs are simply affected. If you've heard a dog, excuse me. This could mean many, many things. Usually sadness, though.
And another very similar example, you might have seen this one before.
As well, I think the college example goes very well with the more corn than you originally expected.
Or more corn than you originally know. originally though I bought enough corn for everybody.
Yeah.
But then that 60% that was unsure.
You should have raised more your hand, you only have like put up four of like five.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, it was like I signed up for this and I don't know if you all did, so
yeah. Coordinated fair, we got really excited.
I'm a little salty.
Then we realized we only had Kroner and it was really strange.
Like the corn. The corn is salty.
Yeah. Right. Can you mind chugging, Justin?
So do ferrets understand letters?
Yes! As you went through, if you very, very. This has been shown that ferrets. They've responded the best to apples. in the worst of ones. They just cannot conceptualize. This study is still out, and you'll be able to understand these guys about that research.
I know you see that.
Yeah. Thank you.
Kids, when you're ready!
No!
Are you?
Oh.